What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the third video of Machine Learning with Python. In previous videos, I have discussed about difference between AI, ML, and DL. And I also discussed some general terminologies which is often being used in this field. So if you haven't watched those videos, check out the description because some of the words we are going to use in upcoming videos. So in this video, we will start with regression. But first, we will learn how to pre-process the data. Because you can't directly train the data after downloading it, you need to do some pre-processing first. So without wasting much time, let's open the IDE. But first, we need to install some important library. So install pandas by pip install pandas. Basically, with pandas, you can import or manipulate the data. Even you can also do some data analysis. Now install numpy by pip install numpy. Working with dictionaries, arrays, and images, you need to know NumPy, and it also enables you to do computation effectively. Now install scikit-learn. So scikit-learn is a collection of data algorithms and tools for machine learning. Now let's import pandas first. So import pandas as pd and import NumPy as np. For this tutorial, we are going to use the dataset of New York Stock Exchange. So from the symbol column, you can see that we have the dataset of like Google, Oracle, Johnson & Johnson, and many more companies. And our dataset contains the stock value from 2010 to 2016. We have open, close, low, high, and volume values. So now let's open the IDE and read the dataset. So pd.read.csv, New York Stock.csv. Now let's print the top 10 value of dataset by head method. So write print data.head 10. Now let's run the code. Here, our dataset is common. So to predict the Google stock value, we need to extract the Google data first. So the symbol for Google dataset is GOOGL. So write data is equal to data square bracket data dot symbol double equal to GOOGL. Now let's run the code. So from the dataset, you can see that it contains the date and symbol column, but for training purpose, we don't need it. So let's get rid of it using the drop method. So here we want to drop the date column, and here x is equal to 1 represent the column, and let's copy it and replace the date with symbol. Let's run the code again. So as you can see in dataset that we have successfully get rid of the date and symbol column. Now let's describe the dataset, but first comment the print headline and write print data.describe and run the code. So with describe, you can view count, mean, standard deviation, minimum, and the maximum value of all the features. You can also see the summary of dataset by info method. So write print data.info. As you can see here, all the column contain 1762 values. So none of the columns have missing value, but it not happens all the time. So we need to do something to overcome this problem. I have made a dataset with missing value. So let's first read it. It's New York 50. Because it contains the 50 row. Now let's replace the data with data 1 and let's run the code. As you can see here, high column has missing value here in 5th row. So to have a clear idea, let's describe and have summary of the data set. So replace data with data 1 and run the code. As you can see here, high column has 3 missing value. And the close column has 1 missing value. We need to do something about the missing value. So we have 3 options, but first let's comment the print line. So the first option is to remove the whole instance with drop na method. So write data.drop na in place is equal to true. Second option is to replace the missing value with some outliners with fill na method. So you can replace missing value with like 9999. The third and the most accurate way to overcome this problem is to replace the missing values with mean and the median value of that column. If you want to fill the missing values in high column, write data square bracket high, and we want to manipulate the high column, so copy it and paste. Now we want to fill the missing values with mean or the median of that high column, so we'll use mean method here. You can also use median method. Now let's first comment the above two line and run the code. Okay, there is some mistake. Okay, write data one instead data and run the code again. So as you can see that all the three missing value have been replaced with mean value. Now let's have a fast recap of what we have done till now. First, we have read the dataset, and then we drop the date and the symbol column from the dataset. And at last, we have seen the three method to fill the missing values. Now let's remove the unnecessary part from our code. Now let's visualize the data so you can have a clear idea about the dataset. So for that, we need to first install matplotlib library. So write pip install matplotlib and hit enter. I already installed it. Now import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Now we want to draw the histogram of our data. So write data.hist and say plt.show and run the code. Okay, maximize the window. So as you can see here, all the columns have most of the data range between 400 to 900, except volume column. It contains data in 10 raised to 7 power. So now let's close the window. We can also visualize relationship between two columns. So let's draw the scatter plot between close and the open columns by using the scatter method from matplotlib. So here we want color blue. So write color is equal to blue. Now let's remove the unnecessary part from our code and hit the run button. So from the graph, you can see that data in column close and data in column open are linearly related with each other. We can also see the correlationship between each column, but first let's comment those two lines. To find a correlationship between each column, here we will use core method. So core stands for correlation. So write data.co. Here I am measuring correlation of all the columns with respect to open column. So write core square bracket open and dot. So we are sorting value in ascending order. So write sort values ascending is equal to true. Okay, now hit the run button. As you can see here, correlation value in open is 1 because we have taken it as a reference. All other columns have value near to 1 except the volume. It has the negative value, meaning it is not related with open. So we need to get rid of it. So copy the drop line, paste it, and replace symbol with volume. So we are removing the column of volume. Now let's print the first 10 line of the code. Okay, remove the unnecessary part first. And here change data 1 to data and hit the run button. So from the data set, you can clearly see that the volume column has been successfully removed. Now the most important part of our code is going to begin. So stay focused. So here we want to predict the stock open value after 10 days. So suppose if we have the value of open, close, high and low on 10th of May and we want to predict the stock value at 20, 10 days in advance. So first we need to define the label column first. So first let's define the forecast is equal to 10. Now we'll define another column. Let's say label. Here we want a label column as 10 value shifted upwards of open column. So we'll use a shift method here and we'll write minus forecast. Now let's run the code. So as you can see here, we have successfully added the label column. So here we will have one problem. So basically we have taken the label column as the 10 values shifted upwards of an open column, right? So we will not have the label value of last 10 data entries in our data set. So we have to remove those 10 rows. So let's use dropNA method. So say data.dropNA and say in place is equal to true. Hit the run button. Here you can't see, but those 10 rows has been removed successfully. Here we need to normalize the data also because the range of the data are different in all the columns. To do that, let's use scikit-learn. So from sklearn import p processing. But first we need to convert our dataset into numpy array. So here we also have to drop our label column. So use the drop method and say label, and here a 1 represent for the column. Now let's make a numpy array of a label column. So say y is equal to np.array and data square bracket label. Now let's print the x and the y and hit the run button. So you can see here, we have a NumPy array of x and y value, but here we need to normalize the data. So say x is equal to preprocessing dot rescale x. Now let's print the x and y again, run the code. You can see here all the values of x are converted between -1 to 1. Now for the training and the testing of our dataset, we need to divide our data into two parts. So we can do this task manually, but instead let's just use trend test split from the sklearn library. Okay, so from sklearn dot model selection import trend underscore test underscore split. Now let's define the variable. So first comment print x print y. Now write x train, x test, y train, and y test equal to train test split x and y, because we want to divide the x and y. Now say test size is equal to 0.15. So meaning we want test data set of 15% of training data set. With random state, we will generate a random number which we'll use to shuffle our data set. So if you don't provide a key parameter random state, then it will shuffle our dataset in such a way that every time you run the code, you will get a different dataset for x and y. So we will not able to predict our model accurately. So we need to provide any integer value to key parameter random state. Here, I am defining a 42 value. So we have divided our train and test data into 85, gem 15 ratio. So now let's print the length of x train and length of x test. Now hit the run button. Okay, so I forgot to write n in sklearn. So write n. So as you can see here, we have 1409 data of train and 263 data of test. That's all for this video. So we have seen complete preprocessing for regression. In upcoming videos, we'll see a basic maths for regression, and we'll also do training, testing, and prediction of our model. Thank you.